Welcome back to the Doctor's Garage. So you join me for part two of fitting security to my Land Rover Defender. In part one, if you missed it, we did the Optimil steering boss, and today we're putting Optimil hinges on my Defender. So watch this video to get some tips and tricks of how to do it, and also just see me fit it for the first time.
These are the hinges I've got on my car at the moment. I do like them. I did originally get them resprayed Kezzy Green, but they have the standard fittings in there. Well, they're actually stainless, but they're standard, so anyone can whip these doors off. And when doors all sell as a pair of three for about £1,200, you can see why these are quite nicked. What we're gonna be doing is swapping the front door hinges out. So you're keeping my same mirror head and mirror arms, but swapping these for hinges that you can't get into, and they are just here. We'll do a couple of clever tricks in regards to how they fit onto the bulkhead that I'm not gonna show here on YouTube, because if you're a thief and you're watching this, you might be looking how to get these doors off with these hinges on. But these are amazingly well-made bits of kit. They are full billet aluminium. They're UK manufactured, and Optimil, I really believe, make the best gear in the game when it comes to Defender upgrades. Step is to take this door card off. So, a bit better now, it's all been cleaned up, and I'm gonna do some soundproofing, like I say, on this area. I'm also, it's not looking too bad in my car, but I'm gonna spray a load of ACF 50 in the bottom of there, because I know the bottom of these doors often rots out with time, so it's a good opportunity just to put a bit of rust coating in there too. So just put a bit of silent coat onto the door panels. You can see already it sounds so much better just with that on it. This dodo matting as well, which is like a foam backed sticky stuff, put that on, even better now, so really pleased with that. To take a door card off to do the hinges is you can do it without doing it, and I've done it before, but you just get to the nuts so much easier like this. If you've got the door card off, you don't lose them, they don't fall anywhere. So for me, I prefer taking it off now because I think it makes it a much easier job. One hinge at a time. You can see I've taken the first hinge off now. I've got some newer these spire clips actually, because sometimes these are a bit corroded and rusted, so I'm gonna put some new ones in there, and then yeah, carry on with the job. A new set of spire clips, I'll put the link in the description for these if you need them, and then also some copper grease. The old ones just look a bit kind of knackered really, so I'm gonna change them with the new ones and put them into here to be able to put the bulkhead side of the hinge on. Now Optimil do quite a smart thing with the bulkhead side of things. Not going to show you how I put that here on YouTube, but if you follow the instructions that you get with Optimil, it's quite easy to do, and it just is another element of security you can get from fitting these hinges. Being very fresh with the new spire clips we've put in there. Bulkhead side of the hinge fitted. I've left it off on the door side for now. So I've put a bit of copper grease in there, and the bolts that you use actually have a unique head for Optimil. So again, another security feature. And on the door side, there's no holes on the outside, so you can't basically get to them. It's all done from the inside, and that means that you cannot take the door off the cars, which makes a big difference when you're upgrading your security on your Defender. Here's the first hinge on, my lower hinge on the left side. So really, really pleased with how it looks. It works really well with the black features that I've got on my Defender. So you've got the two screws that go in the outer side, and then on the inside, quite cleverly, Optimil have designed this. So your bolts go through from here, and again, they've got that special head on, so there's nothing exposed on the outside for people who are trying to nick your doors to see. On to the top one now, to where the wing mirror arm is, and do that one as well. But already, even when I'm opening and closing this door, it feels so much more silky just with having that on there. I didn't realize how much my old hinges were almost grinding when I was opening the door. It's a top hinge taken off. I'm gonna change those spire clips again because they look a bit worn out. And then this is my mirror arm that's coming off. Now I've recently bought these new mirror heads. They're okay, they do a job. They were £30, I think. I did put them on one of the videos I recently did, and they haven't moved since I did that little cheat of having that thing in there actually. If you haven't seen that before, go and check that out. Problem solved on the Defender, having your wing mirror heads that move. That solved that problem. But anyway, these are the arms and they go onto the hinge itself. So gonna fit that hinge on now and do the same as what we did on the bottoms. Again, have seen better days, but they're out now. I might also put a bit of ACF 50 or Lanigard in there too, because this is the side I've got that little bit of corrosion on the inside starting to appear, so I'm gonna put a bit in there before we fit the hinges back on. Top hinge done and the bottom hinge now, and I think overall looks really, really cool in the all black, and the door is properly silky to shut. And in that sound deadening I did as well has also helped make a bit of a difference as well. Take a look, these are new hinges, the all black features, and if we go around the other side, these are my originals. And these do look cool in Keswick Green. I have always liked them, but I'm so much happier now. I know that I've got the security of people not being able to take my doors off. And it all just improves the look. I do think of the Defender having those black features on there. The parts are so much better than the original hinges. So I'm really pleased overall with how that's turned out. What do you need to be able to do the rear door hinges? Well, obviously the hinges, this is the top, the middle, and then the bottom. You need a 13mm spanner just to hold the nuts on the other side of the bolts. And finally, the set of bolts that comes with it, and it has a little special head as well that goes into the top of the optimal bolts. The first step is to take your rear wheel off the door, and that's just to make it a bit lighter, but also just so you can actually get to the access of these hinges. And these are the ones we're replacing today, so top, middle, and bottom. The hinges off, you've got to come on this side where the little nuts are. You've got the bottom middle ones there. You've also got then the top ones just here. So they need to come out in order for you to be able to get the hinge off. That's that middle hinge now removed. If you look, with things like that, I can still shut the door, works absolutely fine. I'm gonna put the new optimal hinge on the middle and that one will be done. There's a hinge onto the door. I've loosely put it on and now we've just got to close that gap there and then put the bolts on the other side and that will hold that side on too. So that is the middle hinge. Fitted, looks really good. Flush on, now gonna move on and do the other ones. That is the top hinge, I've taken that off, got the masking tape on there, just that bit of movement. But to be honest, you can do it like I'm doing it here. If you've got two people, it's really easy for one person to stay inside and one person to come outside, and someone can literally hold the hinges on as you take them off and screw them in, which is what I'm doing for some of these other ones now to make it a little bit easier. I know I keep saying it, but just look how well made this piece of gear is. It is just so nice to hold and it feels so weighty. It's so much better than what originally was put on your Defender. That is now the top hinge fitted. It looks great on, and the middle one, just got this last one to do now. So to be able to put the hinge on this side, you've got to get the bolts from under the inside of the bodywork of the car. So to do that, you've got to go under this wheel arch. And when you're up in here, you want to be looking behind this flap, just above the cross member. And you can see there your two holes that you need to be going through with your new bolts. And they will just pop out straight on there. They are my three hinges all done and looking absolutely brilliant. Got a bit of copper grease on them still, I'll just clean them up, but they look brilliant all on. And the door feels so much smoother to open. So I'm gonna put the back wheel on, just see if the alignment's right with the rear door and see if that weight helps just get things shutting really well. And yeah, overall though, quite an easy job to do. You may need two people at some point, but yeah, enjoyed doing that. And I'm really pleased with how that looks on my Defender.